Hello, this is Fluke again. This is part two of how to do a Kaggle competition in R. So last video, I showed you how to do a very simple model in R and submit it to Kaggle. But we also use some very subpar cleaning functions, okay? So this video is gonna depend that on basically the code base from that previous video. So if you have not watched that video yet, you're gonna be very confused. So basically click here on the screen to watch the previous video and then come back. Okay, I'm gonna wait a little bit so you guys can click it. All right, if you're still here, then that means that you are ready for part two of this video. So, all right, so I have basically saved what I've written in the last video as a script. So I'm basically just gonna rerun all of it. Well, I don't need to write the CSS, but I'll basically run all of it, okay? And maybe I shouldn't have run install that packages again, but that's fine. All right, so we're gonna go back up to where we cleaned the data, okay? So where did we clean the data? So we cleaned the data somewhere up here, right? So notice that the age, we cleaned it with the median, okay? We also cleaned fair with the median, okay? So that is really bad, okay? It's very suboptimal, right? Because if you actually do bucketing and segmentation, we will find that fair of different P classes are different. The median of fair of different P classes are different. The fair of different genders are different. Now, if you can even stack that, right? Maybe fair of females in third class is higher than the median of fair of females in first class, right? So you can start stacking a lot of things and then the median will start to change dramatically. So let us build a predictive model to actually clean in the missing values of our data. Okay, so let's not just make blanket assumptions on the data set by filling in with the median, okay? So let's take a much more educated guess, okay? And then we'll feed that into the actual predictive model, right? So notice that we're building a predictive model to clean missing data so that we can actually get a more accurate predictive model of it, okay? So over here, I'm gonna go ahead and comment out this line, okay? So basically this line is what we don't want to do. Okay, so these two lines, I no longer want to clean with the median. Okay, now this is an example for fair, but you can apply this for age or anything else that is numeric. Okay, and last time I already showed you how to build a classification model in a random forest. You would apply the same concept. Okay, so in this case, I want to build a regression model to predict fair. Now this is also kind of a waste because actually if you look at it, there's only, if I run this line, which is basically gonna query all the missing values of fair, and there's actually only gonna be, oh, in this case, I ran the script through and it went ahead and it cleaned the missing values for me. So I don't wanna do that. So I wanna run the script and have it stop right here, right before it cleans fair. So I'm gonna go ahead and see this brush up here. It's gonna clear all of my objects so I can restart again fresh, okay? So basically I'm gonna select everything up until that point and I'm gonna run the basically everything else. So notice that it cleaned in embarked and it cleaned in median, okay? So I still have to clean in missing values or else the model's not gonna like that I have missing values. And I also have to do this categorical casting here, okay? Which I will do actually now. All right, so now what do we wanna do? All right, let's build a predictive model to predict fair. And because our response class is gonna be numeric, okay, it'll be a regression model. And if you look here, if I run this statement, which is basically find me all the missing values of fair, there's only one, okay? So basically this is gonna be a very wasteful predictive model in a sense that we're gonna build a predictive model just to predict one row. Now, I'm only showing you that because your homework should actually be how do I build a predictive model to predict age, right? Age has 200 and something missing values. That'd be much more useful there. So I'll let you guys do that for homework. But the idea is you can take this code base and convert it into an age predictor very easily. You just switch out the names of the columns. Okay, so let's start. All right, so if we look at Titanic of fair, we can build a linear regression model. So I can easily just call this LM function. But here's a big but. There's two types of linear regression models, right? There's an online gradient descent variant, which is we're not going to cover in this video. But there's also another version, which is an ordinary least squares linear regression model. That's a very simple one that I tend to like to go with. So that one is very susceptible to outliers. Okay, so basically before we do this linear model, we have to filter the outlier. So if we simply do a box plot of let's go find out of Titanic.full of fair. All right, look at that. So anything beyond this, basically this quartile, this whisker, is going to be considered a, what would you call an outlier to this model. Okay, so with that in mind, we want to filter these guys out. So we want to build a linear regression model just based upon these guys, right? So these outliers, we don't want them, because if we build a model to predict on them, this guy, for example, would basically completely throw off our model and basically might bring up our regression model and make it might seem like everyone is synthetically richer than they actually are, or paying more for a fare when they actually are not. Okay, so how do I get this quark? What is this, the value of this whisker? So if I prove over, I can kind of guess it and say that, okay, if you paid more than, let's say, $77 for a fare, okay, and this is me guessing, okay, I'm eyeballing, all right, we'll go ahead and filter it out. But it turns out in R, R actually stores it, okay? So if I just do boxplot.stats, I can actually figure out that out. So basically Titanic.full of fare again. Okay, so notice that this brings me back out all the stats that I can ever want. Now, there is one stat I want, right, which is this guy right here, 65. See that? So this tells me basically the first whisker, okay, the first quartile, the median, the third quartile, and the last whisker, right? So anything above, anyone who paid more than $65 for a fare would go ahead and be, in this case, an outlier. We would filter those guys out. Now, I can very quickly and very easily just build a filter for that, right? I could do Titanic.full of fare is greater or less than or equal to 65, right? Now that builds me my filter right away, and I filtered out the outliers. But that is not how we build scripts, right? Because if this was sales data, the outliers might be, that whisker might be moving, okay? The upper bound might be moving on us, okay? So tomorrow's sales data could change things. So let us actually derive what that is, right? So if I just type in that same command, boxplots.stats, okay? Notice that if I hit enter here, it brings me actually, see this dollar? That means I can reference these things, right? So let's see what happens. If I want something in stats, I would call the dollar sign of stats here, okay? So dollar of stats. And notice I get this back, right? And this is a vector. Okay, so notice I can call that and I can get the fifth vector back. And notice I get 65 back. So this gives me my upper bound, okay? So I'll call this upper.whisker is equal to the fifth quantile. See that? All right, cool. So that number is equal to 65. Now I can go ahead and build my filter, okay? So I can do outlier.filter is equal to Titanic.full of fare that is less than upper.whisker, right? And notice that I'm only basically cleaning the upper bound whisker. There is also a bottom whisker, but notice that it's also zero, so that's fine, okay? So we don't have any outliers that go below the minimum there. Okay, so that's fine. So then we'll go ahead and do that filter. So that gives me a series of true falses. Oh, I have to run this code first. So basically this upper whisker should be 65, right? Upper whisker, there we go. And now we will go ahead and do a filter here. So if I run this should be a series of true falses, right? So in this case, someone paid more for a fare. So I'm gonna put that into basically a filter. Then I'll run that as a filter. Next thing is I'm gonna go ahead and do the actual filtration of the data now. Okay, so Titanic.full of outlier.filter. Okay. And notice that we only want the rows that are basically not an outlier. That's what this means. So if I run this will give me all the rows that aren't outliers. Okay. The next thing is now we can go ahead and build our model, right? So we'll go ahead and do an LM here. Okay, an LM where the formula, okay, we have not defined a formula yet, actually. We haven't told it how to predict yet, okay? So in this case, fare.equation, so what do we want to do? So let's do an str real quick. So basically, str of Titanic.full, okay? How do we want to build this predict model? What is the relationship, right? So we're going to build a model not to predict survived, but we're going to build a model to predict fare, okay? So build me a model to predict fare. And then this tilde will be given, right? So basically it's like y equals a bunch of stuff, okay? So we want it to use everything else, okay? So notice that we're gonna use p class, We're gonna use gender here, so sex plus age, all right, plus sibling spouse, plus parent child, okay, and then plus embarked here. All right, that will be our equation. So fair.equation will be inserted there. So that's telling me that build me a predictive model based upon these other predictors. And notice I'm not using survived, right? Because our future data will not have this column, okay? So we can't rely on it as a predictor, okay? So, and then the data will be the data in the absence of the outlier. So earlier here, I went ahead and did that filter, right? So Titanic of full, where I only want to see non-outliers, right? So that's what's contained in this outlier filter, okay? So I want to go ahead and run the equation line, and I want to run this LM line. But I also want to stuff this LM line into basically a variable, so fair.model, okay? All right, so I'm going to run this, and it's going to build me a predictive model using a linear ordinary least squares model, okay? Next thing is I want to apply this. I want to fill in the missing values that are missing using a predictive model, right? Using the rest of the data sets on that row that has the missing value of fair to fill in the value missing of fair, okay? So we're going to go ahead and do, in this case, a prediction. So predict. Okay, so the problem now is, where is our model? What is our model? So our model will be fair.model, okay? And what is our new data, right? So new data will be any row that has missing values of fair, okay? And then the next thing is we have to define what our features are, okay? And that gets tricky because we have other things in here like passenger ID, we have survived, we have embarked, or not embarked, we have name, all right? We need to tell it not to use those things, okay? So this is where it gets a little tricky, okay? So we have to now query our data to basically isolate the things that we only want, okay? So Titanic.full, we're gonna do a quick query, okay? So how do I find if something is missing in fair, right? So remember, is.na of Titanic.full of fair, okay? This will find all the missing values, okay? Give me back a vector of true falses, okay? That will be our query, okay? So this will be, notice that I can query like this, okay? All right, the next thing is what columns do I want, okay? So notice that not every column is needed, okay? So I only want to query specific columns, right? So in this case, I want to query the columns that were included here. See that? So I'm going to go ahead and do this. I'm going to copy that, and actually I'm going to do some text processing in Excel. Now you can do this manually if you want, but I know that a vector is going to require like a comma right here and quotes in these. So basically I'm going to do a find replacement, right? So I want to find all plus signs with a space before and a space after and replace it with a quote before, comma, space, and then quote, right? So notice if I replace this, this will build me my vector initialization command, right? So notice that I want pclass, sex, age, sibling, spouse, parch, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and close that. And now I want it to tell it, I only want it to use those, query those columns, right? So I'll paste that in here, right? So I want to query only the rows that have missing values of fair. And I only want to see P class, sex, age, sibling, spouse, parch, and embarked, okay? All right, now we can go ahead and fill this in, because basically this is gonna return me the rows that are pertinent to me, okay? So fair.row. Okay, so this will give me a series of rows, but let's just run this first, okay? Okay, so notice that this brings me back the row that has the missing value here, which is awesome, okay? So this row, notice I didn't query fair, that's the job of the model, okay? Now we're gonna go ahead and predict on this, okay? So predict on that, it's kind of a waste because it's only gonna run a prediction on one row, this 1004 row, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and run this prediction. Now this, I'm gonna store that into a label too, but actually let's run it before we store into a label, okay? Oh, I have not run that filter yet. So I'm gonna go ahead and run that filter. So fair.row, okay. All right, so that predict, it's gonna go ahead and predict. So notice that it's gonna predict for that person passenger 1,044 that he or she might have paid $8.25 for fare, if he paid, okay? Awesome. So that prediction actually needs to be thrown back into the data set, okay, so as a replacement. So notice that we kind of just called a prediction and printed it to console. We didn't store it anywhere. So we got to just call this fare.predictions, okay? And then we're going to go ahead and replace it, right? So earlier we showed you that is.na of titanic.full of fare. Okay, so now we need to query which rows have missing values of fare. Okay, so this brings us back a true false vector. This is going to be our query. And we're going to go ahead and tell it we only want to query the fare column. Okay, so wrap all of that in these brackets. And we're going to query that from the titanic.full dataset. And this should bring me back that one row, okay, and the specific NA. And I want to replace that NA with this prediction thing here, okay? So if this query had brought back like 10 lines, right, and the fare predictions should have 10 lines, it will basically just replace them in order, okay? So that's how we'll go in and mark all these predictions. All right, and that's all there is to it, okay? We have gone ahead and filled in missing values for that. So that value is now gone. All right. So before it was an NA, now it should be in 88.2 or something like that. But let's find out. So if I go into my titanic.full and view the 1044th row, all right, I should see that the fare is $82 and or $8.25. Okay. And now I can go ahead and run the rest of the model. Right. Go ahead and run the rest of the model. And treat everything else the same. Do the categorical casting back again. Go ahead and split out back into train and test. Cast the survived in the training set. Tell it to that we want to predict survive given all this other stuff. Use the random forest package, right? Do a library of random forest. Build the random forest. And now we can go ahead and predict on survived, right? And now hopefully our model is making a better educated guess and it wasn't just filling in the median for fare before, okay? So now go back and do that for all the other columns, right? So I think age had a bunch of missing values, so go forth and build yourself a model to predict their age. All right, happy modeling.